Good evening. It's Thursday, March 11th, and Carrie and I are here in the sanctuary. And tonight we'd like to share with you a passage from Philippians. It's from chapter 4, and the verses for tonight are verses 6 through 7. So this is Paul writing to those at the church at Philippi. Be anxious for nothing, but in everything by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. And the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. That's a wonderful passage. It's a helpful passage, especially in the world that we live in today. Now, I want to take that apart for us for just about 1 second and share this with you tonight. We do live in an anxious time, and we live in tax season right now. Tax season has some wonderful way of always coinciding with Lent. And so I never have to worry about anything that I'm not going to have anything to worry about, because I always do during Lent. I've always got taxes on my mind. And certainly the people during the time of Jesus who were living under the taxation of Rome really struggled. So you can imagine what they had on their hearts and minds. And at a time when the world was very anxious, not knowing, especially those who were Jewish, not knowing what was going to happen next. And we find ourselves in 2021 in much the same state. We don't really know what's going to happen next. We're still under a new president. We still are in a pandemic, even though things are getting better and we're all getting vaccinated. And we know that there are more vaccinations to come. And so we are looking forward to that day when hopefully we can take off our mask and we can maybe hug one another again, I hope, at least love each other again, or maybe shake hands or something that expresses the love we have for one another that we so naturally have grown up doing. You know, it's been hard to kind of unlearn that. But whatever the situation may be, we find ourselves in an anxious time. And that's where we are during this Lenten journey of 2021. But it says to us, Paul says to the church at Philippi, that not to be anxious. It's just as plain as that. But in everything, by prayer and supplication, with thanksgiving, let your requests be made known to God. I think that's a beautiful statement, because I think as I look at it, and I think as we come to God with those things that we're anxious about, and maybe other things that we're just concerned about but not quite so anxious, I think about my children coming to me, or your children coming to you, or somebody else coming to you. And I think about how it is when we are very anxious and everything that we need to ask somebody rides on what that person is going to say. If they say, yes, our world is going to be infinitely better, we believe. If they say no, we're going to be rocked to the core and we don't know what we're going to do. But it's interesting to me that Paul is so specific and tells us how it is when we're anxious, how it is to come to God. And what Paul says is we do it with prayer. So we are praying as we ask, and with supplication, and then with thanksgiving. So as we are asking and as we are continuing in our prayer, not just one time, but as we are in this period of time of prayer, we need to remember always to, our hearts need to be thankful for everything that God has already come. We don't go to God and say, God, will you supply this need? You haven't done anything else for me ever, but let's see if you can get this one right. That's not what prayer and supplication is all about, certainly not with thanksgiving. We're asking God to supply our need, the need that we believe we have. And so we're coming in prayer in an attitude of humility, and we're coming with this need that needs to be supplied, and we're thanking God for all that God has already done, because we know that God is a good God. So many times, God does good. God does great things. And unfortunately, it's not God who messes up, although we like to blame God for those kinds of things. But if we're really being sincere and honest, we mess up. Or somebody else messes up, and we go with what they are doing instead of listening to what God has told us to do. But that's the way we're supposed to come. And isn't it interesting when, as I said, you think about your children coming to you or whatever else, you know, I listen much more, just me being a parent, I really do listen when they say, Mom, or when they were growing up, Mom, I really need this for school. You know, I really need to get some more supplies for this science project or whatever it is. I hear that. And when they come and you can tell they've really given it a lot of thought before they even asked that or said that, and then they say, you know, I know that you've already done all of this stuff all year, and I know you've had to spend so much money, and I, you know, I'm just so thankful for everything that you do. Boy, I mean, I can really hear that. Now, that doesn't mean, and I want to be sure that you understand this part, you're not buttering God up. I'm not buttering God up. They're really not buttering me up. But it is that I'm coming with that attitude of gratitude that says, I know that you're a good God, and I know that what you do is for my best interest, is you will me good. And I understand that, God. And as I understand that, that is the way that I come to you when I am in need and when I need to ask you for these things. And then the most beautiful part, maybe, is what Paul tells the church at Philippi will happen. And Paul says that as you come to God with this attitude of gratitude and prayer and supplication, that you will find peace. Because the scripture says, and the peace of God, which surpasses all understanding, will guard your hearts and minds through Christ Jesus. That's excellent. When you come this way to God, you have needs, and that's why you're coming. You're anxious, which is probably over those needs, and that's why you're coming. But the good news is that as God hears you, and as you're in prayer, and you're in conversation, or mainly listening to God, you're going to find peace. And not only are you going to find peace, but God is going to put a guard around your heart, and not only your heart, but around your mind. God's going to be active in your life. God's going to be an active listener, so that not only do you feel differently, not only do you feel that your needs are going to be met, but it's going to be that you have been listened to. And God has taken an active step to guard you. I love that thought process. I would love to know that, and I have to really think about it sometimes, that God is guarding our hearts and minds. Because when you think about how information leaks out today, either over the telephone or Facebook or whatever else, information is leaking constantly. And sometimes I think to myself, I just like to put a guard around myself or my information, around my family, so that nothing ever happens to them. We can't really do that unless we lock somebody up in a room, and even then, obviously, that's not good for them. But God can, and God does, and God will. So tonight I invite you to think on these things and to trust God. And to once again, as you go to God in prayer tonight, remember that when you are anxious and you are in need, all we have to do is to pray. And we come to God in prayer and supplication with thanksgiving in our heart. And things will change. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen.